Hi, this is Mike from Mountain Boys, doing another fly tying special for Drifthook Fly Fishing. And today I'm going to be tying an RS2 Olive on a Dairiki number 310, size 20 here. So, start off with, I've got some A-dot Olive Unithread, and I'm going to start my thread wrap, well, maybe one or two eye lengths back here. I'm not going to snip or break my tag end of this. I'm just going to go ahead and hold moderate tension on it as I wrap back, keeping it on top in the middle of the hook there. So once that's done, it's time to tie in the tail. And for that, I'm using some white nylon microfibbets, which is a fancy way of saying synthetic paintbrush bristles. And I go with white. Just that way, if I want to change the color on them or anything like that, they take color really well with a Sharpie or magic marker. So, but most times I think they're fine enough. You can pretty much always get away with white. If I was doing a gray one or something like that, or PMD, I wouldn't even bother trying to color them. The olive, I think I might, but you can do with that what you will. So to tie these on, I'm going to even them up. I'm going to grab them by the tip ends here, and I'm going to lay them not quite perpendicular across the hook, maybe about a 45 degree angle. And as I start to wrap them around like that, they just go ahead and orient themselves perfectly on top of that hook. So I'll give them a couple wraps. Now I'm going to pull forward on them a little bit just to get the length right. So probably the length of the shank of the hook, maybe just a little bit longer, especially on a small guy like this. Once I get them where I want, I take that tag end that I left there, and I'm going to get it between the fibers. You might need your bodkin to help you out here to be able to see them. Get them to split. Once you do, run that tag end in between them. Go ahead and pull forward on that. The harder you pull forward on that, the more it'll splay out those tail fibers. So once you have them how you want, do another couple wraps forward on that guy, and there you go. That's the hardest part of this fly right there. So once you've given it a couple turns up, you can go ahead and trim that tag end as well as the rest of the tail fiber off. And now it's time to dub the abdomen. For this, I'm going to go with some super fine dubbing, and I'm going to do it in olive. And I'm just going to grab the littlest little pinch here. You don't need a lot. In fact, I think a lot of RS2s that you see, even commercial ones at the fly shops, they've really been overdubbed. So a little bit of dubbing wax on my index finger and thumb, and I'm going to go ahead and twist on this dubbing noodle and work it up the thread a little bit and start to dub my body. Go ahead and dub it forward. Right's about where we started that thread, and you can see I have more than I even wanted, so I might try to peel off a little bit of that. Oop, bent the hook. Like I said, you don't want to overdub this stuff, and I see a lot of them that are. So I'm not going to get the rest of that dubbing out of there. If I'm going to overdub anywhere, I want it on the front end. So I'm going to take my thread back to about a third of the way down the shaft in that hook. And for wing material today, I'm just going to use some white synthetic parapost. So grab a bunch of this. I like to kind of twist the ends a little bit and simp them off flush to each other. Lay it on top. Give it a pinch wrap. A couple more wraps. Back to where you're, whoop, missed it. That's all right. So pinch wrap. One, two, there's three wraps around. Now I'm going to gently pull this back until I've cleared the eye right there in that hook. Right there. Give it one more wrap. Grab a little bit more dubbing. Just enough to cover over the post material as I tie it forward. So, make my dubbing noodle again. Push it up. There we go. It started the noodle. I'm going to go ahead and hold my wing kind of up and forward a little bit. Maybe put two wraps behind before I go ahead and finish it off going forward. Just like that. So, giving it a wrap or two behind just helps it stand up a little bit straighter. So now, go ahead and whip finish here. One, two, three, four. Good. And I broke the thread. So if that happens on you and it doesn't immediately all unravel, go ahead and grab your head cement, or in this case what I'm using is some clear nail polish, and get some glue on that thread head pretty much immediately to lock those in. And odds are it'll stay together just fine. If it didn't come apart on you right when you broke the thread, it's probably just fine now. Just get it locked in. Now, I'm going to hold the wing straight up. I'm going to come down. And when I trim this off, I don't want it to be really any longer than the end of my my dubbed body right there. So I'm going to trim it off. It'll end up ending about right there. It can be easy to over trim or under trim these. So you kind of just get a feel for it. Just about like that. So, if you need to, there's a few stray fibers around. Go ahead and clean those up while you're at it. A little bit of manicure. But there is a size 20 Olive RS2. It's not a terribly hard fly to tie, but just the size of it does present some unique challenges, and getting those micro fibbits to lay just right, that's kind of a challenge too. As far as fishing this, I think Uncle Ralph's favorite RS2 combo is behind a parachute Adams, 18 or 20 inches back, kind of as a dropper emerger off that. So anyway, like I said, this is Mountain Boys doing another special fly tying for Drifthook Fly Fishing, and I'll see you next time.